guys and welcome back to our YouTube channel Learning Pockets and to the very first unit of C Programming from Zero to Hero, Getting Started with C. I hope you all have subscribed the channel and do hit the notification bell icon so that you can get the latest updates related to this course or the upcoming courses. So we just completed the literal part and that too, the real literals and the real literal constant and the integer constants. Now there is turn of character constants. Character constants are simple. Character constant is a single character enclosed in a single quotes. As for example, inverted in quotation Z. So it will be a character constant. It is obvious, and the maximum length of the character constant is 1. And so it is very simple. You just need to have a letter or any character in a single quote and you will be having your character constant. And this maximum length is 1. You cannot exceed that. So they are the character constants. And then before jumping to the next topic, I would like to discuss the escape sequences. Some books may prefer to include escape sequences within the character constant and some may not. So, but they are very essential So any non-graphic character can be represented by using escape sequences, and as escape sequences is represented by a backslash followed by one more character. You can find the backslash, I guess, above the shift key, or if above the shift key, I guess. And the next slide will clear you that what are the escape sequences. These are the special characters that are used to print a special thing or do some special characters in the console. So for new line, if you want to if you want the cursor to shift to the new line, then you need to include slash n, and we will be using slash n a lot in our program. Then we have horizontal tab, which is given by slash t, and then backspace with slash b. Then we have carriage return or audio bell, and there are lots and lots there are a lot more that we will be using. I hope you will understand them more clearly when we will be creating our very first C program. So let's move to the next topic, that are punctuators. So punctuators, same as any language, that for say English, we have commas, we have colons and something, so, and full stop. For punctuation, these are known as punctuations of the grammar. And similarly, we have punctuators for programming language to enhance the readability of the program, and they are necessary to use also. And in C language, semicolon is used as the full stop. You need to have semicolon at the end of each instruction. You need to have a semicolon. Braces will define a particular block, and each of them has its own use. Then we have operators. Operators, as in mathematical operators, you can say. Operators are the tokens that trigger some computation or the action when applied to variables or some objects. Similarly, as the mathematical operators, like we have multiplication, division. So we have arithmetic operator, plus, minus, multiplication, division, and modulus. Modulus returns the remainder after the division. Increment, decrement operator, relational operator, logical, conditional. And you need not to worry if you don't know what are these. We are going to discuss the operators in its own unit. Operator has its own unit, an own lecture on it, and we will be discussing it in detail also. So no need to worry about it. So this was all about the tokens in C, and tokens in C. And in very next video, we will be writing our very first C program. I hope that will be very exciting for you guys. And the installation for the IDEs, installation of the IDEs instructions will be given down in the description. So do check them before you jump to the next lecture. So check them out and install your IDE, get it set up so that you can write your program simultaneously with me. So let's take the leave for today.